Hello, I am Ashwar. Today I am going to teach you class 11 physics chapter number 10. In this, mechanics of fluid. So, first of all, today this topic our topic is that fluid. But what is a fluid? You have not understood what is a fluid. You have seen any kind of fluid? Whenever you are ill on the time or whenever you are sick on the time, doctor suggests you depends only on fluid. What it does mean? You are drink juice, then drink water. So this is the type of fluid. Whenever fluid is both are then first liquid. First thing is liquid, and as well as second, it is a gas. So this both things it is known as a fluid. What is that? It is known as a fluid. So whenever we are talking about that the liquid and gas mechanics, all that time it is our one of the branch of physics. It is known as a fluid mechanics. Now, first of all, what is fluid? What is fluid? It means we are studying about the liquid and gas. Those who have any kind of shape, what will happen? It have any kind of shape. So I was written as this that any kind of shape of fluid. So yes, there is no any kind of shape. Why? Because whenever, so you see, use one already, whenever you are taking one glass of water, then you put in a one mouth, then what will happen? The same of water, it is become like as a mouth. Then again you are put in a dish, on that time what will happen? It is a become as a look like as a dish. So it means there is any kind of shape. Why this thing is happen? Because molecule distance between or molecules of atom. So what is distance between molecules? So molecule of atom. So see here, whenever we are talking about the solid, all that time it is a distance, it is a very much small between two atoms is that. But whenever we are talking about the solid, so it is it have whenever we are talking about the liquid, on that what will happen? There is about much distance larger than the solid is there. And whenever we are talking about the gas form on the time, it is very much distance from the solid as well as the liquid. So what will happen? The liquid and gas, it is trying to become an entire volume. But what liquid have not spread over the entire volume, but gas is trying to spread over the entire volume or container. So see here, whenever we are taking as a liquid on the time, in the liquid, what will happen? It is a become as a this, how much time is that? It is become this much only. But whenever, so you are so whenever you are going to the drink of bring the coat, okay? On that time what will happen? Then if you have open the knob on that time, okay, open the cap on that time what will happen? It is trying to come outside. You are safe, and then what will happen? It is trying to come outside. As well as if you are put in the any baking soda, okay, on that time what will happen? It is trying to enlarge and become to entire surface, it is fulfilled the entire surface. What will happen? There is a become a gas. What will happen? There is a become a gas, and due to the gas, what will happen? It is trying to see. This is a solid atomic distance. See, this is a liquid atomic distance, and also this is our gas atomic distance. So, see here, it is trying to become entire volume. So try to become a straight entire volume. Okay, so it is become entire volume. So that's why whenever we are talking about that, this kind of situations, this is our fluid mechanics. Now see here, if there are any kind of stress applied on fluid, then what will happen? See, whenever you are forced applied water on that time, what will happen? It is going to the spring. It is going to the back side. It is going to the upward side. So we are not applying the time on that time. On the particular volume, we are applying the force. Or it is our stress is that. So on that time, what we have done? It is become to the spring over the surface. It is trying to become over the surface. But whenever we are talking about that, the solid on that time, what we have done? The solid have a any solid. We are applying the force on the solid on that time. What we have done? But whenever we are talking about that, the liquid or as well as gas, so can we apply the pressure on gas? Can we? Yes, we can apply pressure on gas as well as liquid, but not apply the stress. Stress is if this is a pressure. Why we are applying the pressure? Because force per unit area. We can pressurize to the balloons. We can pressurize to the balloons because balloon have a gas is there inside, field of fluid that. But there is a applying the pressure to become a small or to become a aligned to particles and decreasing the separate particles distance. So we can pressurize to there, but we cannot apply the things. So we have another topic is that pressure. Now first thing is that what is a fluid? It is not. Is the same and same of fluid? No. Okay, this is the now we are talking about the pressure. What is the pressure? So pressure is that whenever the force is again look like there is a stress. So what is happen? Whenever we are talking about, see, whenever we are talking about the force per unit area. Okay, force per unit pressure is that it is equals to force per unit area. So see, this is force per unit area. It means we are applying any particular area. So that means it is our pressure is that. What will happen? It is our pressure is that. And see, this is our what will happen? Area and force is that in which direction you are applying. It is mentioned. No, there is a scalar quantity, negative scalar quantity is there. So why we have why? Because whenever we are applying the pressure on that time, what we have one? It is a compressed. Okay, what we have one? It is a compressed or it is a maybe stretch is there. So that's why we are taking this a pressure is a force per unit area. But suppose we are just consider as what we have one? We have compression is that whenever just we are consider as that A our area. This whenever you use what the whenever you put your spoon on your palm on that time you can feel there is any kind of stickiness. No, why? There is because surface contact surface. But whenever you are putting a needle and still little bit going trying to the put hardly on that time, what will happen? It is harm to you. Why? Because of the contact area. What will happen? Contact area. It is depend on pressure is depend on the contact area. So this is the pressure is already depends on area. So contact area. How much area is that? Due to this phenomena, we can say suppose you are taking as contact area. The pressure is that whenever you are taking as what we have an area is very small. What we have area you are taking. Very much small on that time. So delta is our what we have a pressure P is equals to limit delta A tends to 0. You are taking as our value is that what will happen? It is 10 to 0, it is 0.00000001 or 0 something is that. So it is 10 to 0, it is right to become a 0, but it is actual value is not a 0. So what is that? It is 0.00001 is that. So I am going to show you that what will happen. The delta is tends to 0, so we can return as delta p divided by delta a. Delta p by delta a. The change in, sorry, delta f by delta f. The change in force per unit area. Okay, so we can get that the pressure, and it is applied, and it is maybe delta f by delta a is that. So see here, we can return this things again. P is equals to, we can return this things, p is equals to minus d f by d a is that. What will happen? Minus d f by d a is that. So see, this is our pressure quantity for the very small amount of area. What will happen? This is now pressure. How much pressure apply for the small area? Small area. So see here, this is our quantity is that. Now what is the unit of pressure? Pressure is that the force is equals to, it is measured in newton, and also area is measured in meter, but area is that, so unit is written as meter square. So unit is that pressure is equals to newton meter plus 2 minus 2, or we written as p is equals to pascal. Pascal. So see, one Pa is that pressure unit, Pa is that, P pressure is equals to newton meter plus 2 minus 2 is that. Okay, now it is our scalar quantity, it is our vector quantity is that. Now see, sorry, now pressure of P is equals to 1 pascal is that. Now what value of 1 pascal is equals to 1 into 10 raised to 3 kilogram per meter square. So this is our value of that, P is equals to 10 raised to 3 kilogram per meter square. So see, now see, this is our pressure is that. Now we are talking about that the pressure is that. So we have another quantity is that, it is our density. Density. What is density? Now we have shown the density is that. What is the density? First of all, density is that, it is represented, it is related to the, again, density, it is related to the our this thing, fluid mechanics. Why this fluid mechanics? Because you have shown that the water, yes, already all the colors show the water. You shown the oil, yes, maybe. Okay, then you have shown the honey. Honey, maybe some little bit percent, I am not sure. But most of them are not shown the honey. What is honey? So whenever you are, so see here, density. What is the density? Density, it means mass per unit volume. What will happen? It is a mass per unit volume. So it, what it means? So see here, whenever you have shown that the honey, so try, we are trying to the put your hand in the water. On that time you can get any kind of so see here, whenever you put your hand in the water, on the time you cannot get any, you just feel this water is that, but just little bit of water molecules are touched on your hand. But whenever you are putting your hand into the oil, or maybe you are in your home, your food oil. Okay, so on that time you can put on that time, what will happen? It is just a more than water. But whenever you have put your hand in castor oil, or maybe in the honey, on that time what will happen? It is your most all hand become a maybe honey, look like all honey touch on your hand. So this is the density. Why? It have a much density. Honey have much density. Less than have a custard oil. Less than have a food oil. Less than have a water. So this is the density. Why? How can we clarify this density? Because it is how how much dense is that. So due to this density, we can put that, just suppose we have taking 1 kilogram honey and we are taking as a 1 kilogram oil. So the volume of honey and volume of food oil, it is different. Why? Because of the density. Whenever the density is more, then it is come in small number of amount. We can easily fill the 2 kg, 2 or 3 kg honey in the 2 liters of water. But whenever we are going to the fill 2 liters oil, food oil, on that time it is full filled. Why? We cannot more than taking the bottle size. So this is the basic difference. So whenever 3 kg honey, it is taking a small amount of the space and it is taking a large amount of space. So this is the difference in the density. This is the difference. I am going to explain to you what is the difference between density. So this is the basic difference between the density. Now see here, how can we say the density? It is how to relate them. So how, see here, the number of mass, see M is our mass, or anything is that, mass is that, and now mass M divided by volume. So what it is, it will be reduced to the density. And density is our scalar quantity that. It is a scalar quantity and it have any kind of dimension, directions is that. So see, it is a, in which direction we cannot see, but ratio we can say this is the ratio in this direction, or ratio in that direction. So see, this is our scalar quantity, and see, this is our scalar quantity. And now the unit of density. So mass, it is written is in kilogram, and volume, it is become a measure in the meter. So it is a become a meter cube is that. So we can get that the unit of density is equal to kilogram meter is to minus 3. Kilogram meter is to minus 3 is that. So it is a unit of our density. Now unit of density. Now see, if you are making as a 1 into 10 is to 3 kg for water per meter cube. So it is a value of for the density for particular water. So it is representing, it means in the 1 meter cube we can feel the 1 into 10 is to 3 kilogram water is that. So see, this is our density of water. If suppose that this much value, okay, approximately value is that. So see, if you are filling that in 1 meter cube of box, this much value we can feel in the, this much value of water we can put in this side. So fill this in the box. So I hope guys you understood this my topic. See, first thing is that fluid mechanics, in the fluid mechanics we understood the what is the fluid. Second thing is that is the shape of fluid. So yes, we can understand also that after we are talking about the pressure. Pressure is that, what is the pressure? Pressure is equal to force per unit area, and it is represented as negative quantity. Yes, the density also, density is our positive quantity is that. So see, force per unit area, pressure is negative quantity. Also we can understand the density. Okay, so I hope guys you have understood all these 3 points, and if any kind of doubt, if any kind of problem, then you guys comment.